FM News. On point. The news on XFM. I'm Chris Tim. President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni has confirmed that government has suspended Facebook services in Uganda following their continued interference in Uganda's politics. On Saturday, Facebook blocked most of the accounts used by the NRM handlers, saying they breached the company's operating procedures. Ugandan head of state Museveni, while addressing the nation last night ahead of the elections tomorrow, said that the government cannot allow Facebook to continue interfering with Uganda's politics with their selfish motives.
Now, the other day, some of the groups, I think it is called Facebook or something like that, decided to block the NRM message senders, targeting them. Why would anybody do that? So when I heard about that, I told our people to warn those people, say, please, that social channel you are talking about, if it is going to operate in Uganda, it should be used equitably by everybody who has to use it. If you want to take sides against the NRM, then that group will not operate in Uganda. Uganda is ours, it's not anybody's. Those Facebook and those groups did not respond, I hear, and I'm sure the government has closed the social media, those channels of Facebook and I don't know which one. This is unfortunate, but it is unavoidable. There's no way anybody can come and play around with our country.
Museveni also asked the Electoral Commission to suspend the elections at any polling station where the biometric voter verification system fails to work, to avoid cases of multiple voting.
I'm glad the Electoral Commission has finally brought a system which is foolproof. This is the one where you can only vote if you show your fingerprint. Therefore, I appeal to the Electoral Commission to do not allow any voting where the thumbprint is not used. I know there are some election officials who have been colluding with the criminals where they want to interfere with the machines so that they claim that the machines are not working and therefore they should vote using ID cards. Some of the ID cards have been faked. They are not genuine, and some of they want to introduce new names on the new ballot paper. If anything like that happens, my appeal to the Electoral Commission is that then voting on that polling station should not take place. They should suspend it until the issue of the machine is solved, so that everybody votes through the machine.
He also asked the public to turn up on the 14th day tomorrow to exercise their rights of electing leaders in high numbers.
Peaceful citizens, I held a meeting with the security forces. They are ready to defend you. Therefore, the chance to vote. You go out and vote. We shall. Nobody will intimidate you. Nobody will attack you. If anybody tries to do that, we shall get him or her. So therefore, don't fear anything. Go out and vote. You saw how the rioters were defeated in Kampala here. There's no threat we cannot defeat. Don't miss the chance to vote. You go out and vote. We shall defend you. We have got all sorts of means, simple means and complex means. There's no part of Uganda where we cannot reach, if not on foot, but by air, using all sorts of modern technology. I urge all citizens to keep peace. Keeping peace is a duty. It's not a favor.
The UPDF's representative in Parliament, Brigadier General Felix Kulaije, has appealed to the public to cooperate with security during the elections. Kulaije told XFM that people have to work with security personnel and follow lawful orders to avoid clashing. He assured the country of peaceful elections.
I want to assure you that the country is safe, the country will continue to be safe and stable. Anybody who wants to bring confusion, anybody who wants to displace the country will be dealt with. Come Thursday, go cast your vote and go back home. Trust the candidate agents that you put there because they are mean enough, almost 50. We don't need additional people at the polling station. You can come back to watch the counting because counting is public. Cooperate with security to guide you, to secure you.
In world news, a coronavirus vaccine developed by China's Sinovac has been found to be 50.4% effective in the Brazilian clinical trials, according to the latest results released by researchers. It shows the vaccine is significantly less effective than previous data suggested, barely over 50% needed for regulatory approval. The Chinese vaccine is one of two that the Brazilian government has lined up. Brazil has been one of the countries worst affected by COVID-19. In sports, Everton maintained their challenge for a Champions League spot with a 2-1 victory at Wolves, thanks to Michael Keane's 77th minute winner. The Toffees' sixth away win in the league this season lifted them to fourth in the table, 11 points with the third place Leicester and only four off the lead held by Manchester United. They got off to a brilliant start when Alex Iwobi fired home in the fifth minute for his first goal in 38 Premier League appearances. And that's the latest XFM news.
XFM News on point.